Mark.
Tara.
Matt.
Lindsay.
Dale.
Tasha.
Ricky.
Carrie.
Jason.
Nina.
JC.
Alana.
Kevin.
Rona.
Josh.
My Lynn.
Blaine.
The party.
Terry.
Fred.
And you.
Welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club.
Today we're getting into the holiday spirit with a special Christmas show.
We've got a fresh party video for you. It's sugar is sweet.
And a hot holiday dance number of our own.
But to get things off to a cheery start, let's watch this holiday classic.
Excuse me. I'm Wendy Wallow. I'm supposed to start work here today.
Oh, right, BL. Well, I'm Miss Gwynn, your supervisor. And don't worry, this job is very easy.
Yes, that's what they all say.
You just spread happiness and holiday cheer. You can spread good cheer, can't you?
Well, perhaps if you had a nice guest
job, you'll be fine.
Well, what exactly do I have to do?
Oh, can you just come on over here and hand out these candy canes and recite this little poem. Go ahead, give it a try.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, because they were all out shopping at Massey's Holiday Department Store, where we have really great bargains, so just take a look. This poem is terrible. It doesn't even rhyme.
I'll have you know I wrote that, Miss Wallow.
Free verse. Very clever.
Yeah, well, I'll be in the back.
Thanks. Excuse me.
Yes, what is it? I'm very busy.
Happy holidays.
Oh, yeah? What's so happy about it?
Well,
I just lost the Morgenthaler account. Do you know what that means?
Well, actually, no, I don't. But I'm supposed to read you this little poem.
Well, make it quick. I'm very busy.
Okay. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, because they were all out shopping at Massey's Holiday Department Store, where we have really great bargains. So just take a look.
You call that a poem? It doesn't even rhyme.
Yes, I know.
Well, is that it? Look, I gotta go.
Wait,
I'm very busy.
No, wait. I'm supposed to give you this little candy cane.
Oh, fine. I suppose you want me to have cavities,
no,
huh?
No.
I suppose you want me to have pencil surgery.
No,
maybe
I didn't know.
Maybe you don't even care if I'm allergic to Novocaine,
no,
huh?
No, I didn't know.
You don't see a fair problem here.
No, there is.
Because of the strange little red elf here, I probably lost the Henderson account, too. Look, I gotta go. I'm very busy. Happy holidays.
Come again.
Miss, don't antagonize the people. Just hand out the candy canes. Read the poem. Make them happy. Got it.
Yes, Miss Gwynn. Excuse me.
Oh, look, Felicity, an elf. Isn't she precious?
Oh, Mother, really?
Elves are fictitious.
No, we're not. We're Santa's helpers. It was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring.
Oh, you are just darling.
Please don't mush my face. Ow!
See, I told you she wasn't real. Real elves don't feel pain.
Ow!
Don't you have some cute little elf-type presents for us?
Oh, right. Would you like a candy cane?
Oh, how dare you! I have told my child never to take candy from strangers.
Have a nice day. Excuse me. Would you like a candy cane? There. Oh, no! Oh, no!
Oh, I don't believe it. I just spent every last dime I had on these presents. And you...
You
wouldn't have done them all. Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
'Twas the night before Christmas.
Don't live like that. I'm ruined.
Ruined.
Hey there, Bunky. So what you selling?
Well, actually, I'm not selling anything.
Ah, come on, come on, come on. You can't fool me. So, how much do you want for those candy canes?
Well, it's free.
Yeah. Yeah, nothing's free in this world, lady. Sure, I'll take this candy cane now. And before I know it, there'll be process servers at my door demanding money for a washing machine I never ordered.
Do you hear me?
Ruined!
You know, you're not the first little red girl who's tried to sell me unwanted merchandise.
You leave that poor little girl alone. Go, shoot, shoot.
Are you all right, miss?
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome.
People are acting so strangely today, and I just don't understand it. It must be the hustle bustle of the holiday season and all, but it's just crazy. I just don't understand.
Yeah, hold that.
What is that?
Stop!
Oh, I did it. You're her accomplice.
No, I'm not. I've never seen
it. Miss Marlowe, don't say it.
I'll go quietly. And you think you have problems?
I can't believe it. Fired on Christmas Eve.
Trouble, Miss Wallow?
Huh?
I said trouble, Miss Wallow.
How did you know my name?
Oh, I have a list. I checked it twice.
Well, you see, I keep getting fired from all my jobs, and it's not my fault.
Oh, don't worry about it, dearie. I have a feeling this is going to be the merriest Christmas of your life.
Really?
Would I lie to you? Now, what one thing in the whole wide world would you like most for Christmas?
Well, that's really very simple. All I ever wanted was a really good job. Any job, just something I wouldn't get fired from.
Is that too much to ask? One good, steady job?
Give me a break, kid. I'm only Santa Claus. Have you ever considered a pony?
now it's time again for Mouse Mail, the part of the show where we answer a few of the letters sent to us by our members at home.
We've been receiving so many Christmas cards and holiday greetings, we thought we'd share some with you.
Our first card comes from Cindy Campanera from Toronto, Canada. Cindy writes, "Dear Mickey Mouse Club, happy holidays."
Well, thank you, Cindy. That was really sweet of you to say. And on behalf of Dale, myself, and everyone on the Mouse Club, we'd like to wish everyone at home good health, goodwill, and good cheer.
Hold on, hold on.
Captain Breakdown.
Good health, goodwill, good cheer? Give me a break.
Captain Breakdown, it's the holiday season.
Yeah, you're supposed to give season greetings.
Oh, why waste your breath, Alana? The holiday season only lasts a short while, then it's back to homework and bad weather. Besides, you know you're not getting any of the presents you wanted, unless you've definitely been hoping for socks and underwear.
Captain Breakdown?
Are you always such a downer?
Always. Well, I'd love to stay and deck the halls, but there's many a Christmas party going on, and I've got lots of mistletoe to tear down. Bye-bye.
That guy is a total bring down.
Today, Kevin and I, our driver Dan, and Bill Nye the Science Guy aren't in warm, sunny Florida.
We wanted to go to the North Pole.
You know, Santa, the elves,
yeah.
Reindeer.
And we wound up in Alaska. That's right, Alaska.
Today we're going to go on an amazing adventure. Do you guys know what a glacier is?
Not
ice.
Well,
it's ice, yeah, but it's a river of ice. It's always flowing. You want to see one?
Yeah.
It's about a 20-minute hike. You up to it?
Let's go, you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. Come on.
Some 2 million years ago, about 30% of what is now the United States was covered with glaciers. In fact, the Great Lakes and the Great Salt Lake were carved by melting glaciers. Today, Alaska still has over 5,000 of them, some almost 50 miles wide. That's over 850 football fields.
Is that it right there?
Yeah, see how big it is?
It's enormous. Huge.
Bill, how did this huge rock get here?
The glacier pushed it down here and left it.
The glacier pushed it?
Yeah, it's big and heavy, isn't it? Yeah, and all this stuff.
I mean, everything?
Yeah, all these big piles of dirt were all pushed down by the glacier, and that's called moraine, glacier moraine.
Moraine is all the dirt and rocks in front of the glacier that get pushed ahead. This glacier has receded or melted, and this is what's left.
Bill, what is this?
What does it look like, Kevin?
Well, it looks like stone, like marble.
Yeah.
Like marble.
But it's actually solid ice. Look at it.
What about that black section?
Well, that's dust. Rock that's been caught up in it. In fact, if you look closely, you can see a rock that's been embedded in there for a long, long time.
But what is this stuff?
Yeah.
Is it volcano ashes?
No, it looks like it, though.
Yeah, it does.
This powder was solid rock, and it was
rock?
Ground up by the action of the glacier. That's like how big
powder.
And heavy glaciers are. Yeah, look at this.
I know.
Isn't that wild?
It's dust.
It's solid
heavy
rock.
Glacier.
It's something else, huh? Let's look at some other stuff.
All right.
Here we are, guys. The Matanuska Glacier. Matanuska, that's the name of it. Took us about a half hour to walk
in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's something, isn't it?
What exactly is a glacier?
A glacier is a river of ice, and it flows downhill. And the ice forms over thousands of years. It takes thousands of years to make a glacier, and it's snow. The snow falls, and it doesn't melt. It just keeps building up and building up and building up, and eventually the weight of all that snow makes very strong ice. And down the hill it goes. Let me show you. Here I've got a little bit of snow in a tube. And down the bottom is a little bit of liquid water. Okay, Kevin, you're the thousands of years of snowfall.
Okay.
Give it a push. You're going to compress that snow. Now watch, down there at the bottom, it turns clear. It turns to solid ice.
Yeah.
Down at the bottom.
So that's how a glacier forms. But
exactly.
It just keeps
the
going.
The pressure of the snow makes... solid ice.
The ice here at Matanuska is about 150 feet thick.
Look at that. That's ice.
It's
almost like rock, isn't it?
Solid.
Yeah.
Anyway, everything around here, all that we can see right now is this solid, solid ice. Isn't that
wild? What's the difference between glacier ice and household ice?
Yeah.
Well, you know, there's really not that much difference. I mean, it's clean water that's fallen from the sky and frozen solid. The only difference between this and your freezer is around here, it's cold. It's really cold.
Why are these big boulders cracking up like this?
Well, it's actually ice. They're not really rock boulders. They're big chunks of ice. And the reason is, if you're a big piece of ice and you flow downhill, you come to a sharp edge, you start to bend and break like that. Those distinct, sharp, wide cracks are called crevasses. But anyway, along with the crevasses, you get these big chunks of ice. And they're all over the place. Look at them. The freezing cold temperatures in Alaska create a natural environment for the huge glaciers. Frequently, temperatures drop well below the freezing level. This may be ideal for glaciers, but for people, warm clothes are a must. And because of the deep snow, special shoes are also in order.
These are weird.
Oh,
yeah. Look good. You're wearing snowshoes. See, now what they do, they spread your weight out over a lot of snow, and then you don't sink in.
So who thought of them?
Well, they were designed based on a design that this guy uses right here. Take a look. This is the snowshoe hare. See, look at his feet. They spread his weight out so much that he doesn't sink into the snow. It allows him to run around on the top. Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
So humans came along later and made these things.
Smart.
Pretty cool idea. Well, guys, what'd you think?
Amazing. They loved it.
Bill, since this is probably the closest we'll ever be to the North Pole, do you think that we could stop by and see how Santa's doing?
Yeah, just a short detour on the way home.
Yeah.
Well, the sun's over there and north. Well, must be out that way someplace. Mm-hmm. Can't be too far. Sure, why not? It's only 5 below 0.
Bye, guys.
Happy holidays.
Season's greetings.
From the makers of Bar Mitzvah on Elm Street comes another horror classic.
Fire the electroblasters. We'll put these earthlings in the dark for at least 8 days.
Yes, Commander Gimmel.
Attack of the space dreidels. Don't see it after sundown.
No, Bobby, you cannot put army men on the Christmas tree. It looks bad for TV. Oh, hello there. Lurleen Cheatwood here. Welcome to my house. And, of course, you know what time of year it is, don't you? Christmas time, because I have my Christmas apron. And we're going to show you how you can make a few things to brighten up your holiday season. For instance, you can take just ordinary cola, put it in a ceramic mug, add a few of these flavored cinnamon candies right here. Be sure you get your parents' permission first. Pop it into the microwave. Heat it up, and there you have hot mulled cola. Of course, it's not Christmas without gingerbread men, and you can make your own into an ornament by cutting out sandpaper, sandwich two of these together, and you get this. Put a little hook on the top with a paper clip, and decorate it, of course, again with cinnamon candy dots. And there you have a little ornament for your Christmas tree. And you know what? Helpful hint. Every time you cut sandpaper with your scissors, you sharpen your scissors. Of course, it's always fun to wear something Christmassy, and don't I know it. You can make something out of a coat hanger like this. Bend it. Be careful when you bend coat hangers. Bend it like that. See? Take another coat hanger and bend it like that. Tape the two together and add a little tinsel on top. And what you get is this. It's a halo you can wear around. Place it underneath your shirt like this. Isn't that wonderful? And it's so festive. Bobby, now I told you not to mess with that tree. Now go watch cartoons with your father. You can make some wonderful holiday decorations out of an ordinary magazine. Take each page and fold it down onto itself like this. Go through the whole magazine. Then you'll spray paint what you get and look what you discover. A beautiful little centerpiece, it's a Christmas tree here. Or add a doll's head or a styrofoam ball and put a little choir book right there. You have a choir person or... Yes, Bobby, that is what you made. Isn't that wonderful? It's not very Christmassy, but it is green. Oh, I do love my... hot mulled cola. But it wouldn't be Christmas at our house if it weren't for the lighting of the great apron. So, from our house to your house, Merry Christmas, everybody.
special wouldn't be complete without a medley of holiday songs. So, grab some fruit cake, throw another log on the fire, and wrap some tinsel around someone you love. Here's our Mickey Mouse Club Christmas medley.
Yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Yeah. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. In the shine.
Time in Hollis, Queens. Mom's cooking chicken and collard greens. Rice and stuffing macaroni and cheese. And Santa put the gifts under the Christmas tree. Decorate the house with lights at night. Snow's on the ground, Snow White so bright. In the fireplace is the Yule log. Beneath the mistletoe as we drink eggnog. The rhymes that you hear are the rhymes of carols. For each and every year we bust Christmas carols. All about. The time is now, yo, the place is here.
The whole wide world is filled with cheer.
My name is D-Mac with the mic in my hand. And I'm chilling and cooling just like the snowman.
So open your eyes,
lend us an ear.
We want to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Hotel of the Mickey Mouse Club. It offers the best of all worlds, a relaxed family atmosphere in the very heart of the Walt Disney World Resort.
MSC is always in the groove.
I will.
Get it? Listen up.
What?
Learn.
MSC.